Just minutes before all of this back and forth, President Trump's counselor and senior advisor Kellyanne Conway was asked at the White House about the president's racist comments.
He should be talking about it.
Following up on the previous question, if the president was not telling these four Congress women to return to their supposed countries of origin, to which countries was he referring?
What's your ethnicity?
They said go home.
Why is that relevant?
Yeah. No, because I'm asking a question. My ancestors are from Ireland and Italy.
My own ethnicity is not relevant to the question I'm asking.
No, it is, because you're asking about, he said originally. He said originally from.
I am asking.
And you know everything he has said since, and to have a full conversation.
So are you saying that the president was telling the Palestinian people?
The president's already commented on that.
The president's already commented on that,
and he said a lot about this since that one tweet.
Was
no, he's put out a lot of tweets, and he made himself available to all of you yesterday.
Yes, he has.
He's tired. A lot of us are sick and tired of this country, of America coming last, to people who swore an oath of office. Sick and tired of our military being denigrated. Sick and tired of the Customs and Border Patrol people, the protection people I was with, who are overwhelmingly Hispanic, by the way, in McAllen, Texas. Sick and tired of them being, no, you don't understand, because you didn't go. Being criticized, being doxxed.
A very heated exchange there between Kellyanne Conway and a reporter. That reporter joining me now, he is Andrew Feinberg, a White House reporter for Breakfast Media. Andrew, you say that by asking about your ethnicity, which she did very clear there at the beginning of that clip, that Kellyanne Conway confirmed what the president meant. Explain that.
Well, not by asking initially, but when I asked her how it was relevant, she said the president was talking about where these congresswomen in question were, as she put it, originally from, which in the case of everyone except Congresswoman Omar, who was born in Somalia and came here as a child, is the United States. And so, at least to my thinking, and I think to a lot of the people who were around me, like colleagues, she was essentially saying what she had denied only seconds before, which was that the president was not suggesting that the two African-American congresswomen could go back to Africa, or Congresswoman Ocasio-Cortez could return to Puerto Rico, or similar, if they don't like his policies, which he often equates as not liking the United States.
What went through your head when you started in this back and forth with her?
I thought it was bizarre. I mean, she frequently responds to questions I ask her by asking questions of her own. A few weeks back, when I asked if the 4th of July event the president put on was nonpartisan, why was the RNC handing out tickets, she asked if I knew why we celebrate the 4th of July. So it's something I'm used to from her, but it's still felt very weird to be asked about my own personal background.
Right. She's nothing if not combative, but this was also a very different turn for her. Now, this doesn't really have anything to do with this debate. You are Jewish. You said after this that you didn't find the exchange with Kellyanne Conway to be anti-Semitic. She tweeted in response to that, saying, "In fact, that same gaggle, I made clear my outrage at the anti-Semitic comments flowing so easily out of Ilhan Omar's, out of the congresswoman, and how absurd it was that the House could not condemn her by name in a resolution back in March." So you didn't find any of this to be anti-Semitic?
No, and I was responding actually on Twitter, sadly, to someone who asked if she was trying to get at the fact that I was Jewish, or if there was an anti-Semitic overtone to what she asked, and I didn't detect that. I just saw it as a deflection that, in her case, went wrong, and she ended up confirming, as I said, the thing she denied moments before.
But don't you think that there's a way to deflect, to spin this, to move on to a different subject? She really wanted to engage, and not just engage, but really heatedly as well.
Yeah, and she kept bringing things back to Congresswoman Omar and this resolution that the House considered several months back. But we're no longer talking about that, because we're talking about the President of the United States. And Congresswoman Omar's comments about Israel and various lobbying groups that advocate for Israel can be taken in different ways, depending on who you talk to. But the president's tweets starting this past weekend, I mean, there's really not many ways to look at them except as racist.
When you look at at what was said today, and then you compare that to what her husband, George Conway, wrote in the Washington Post. And this is not the first time that these two spouses have been at odds over the president's comments and his policies. George Conway wrote, "Naivete, resentment, and outright racism, roiled in a toxic mix, have given us a racist president." This is a new one. This puts senior advisor Kellyanne Conway in a rather awkward position.
I don't envy her, and I don't want to. I don't want to guess as to what's going on in a marriage. Not being married myself, I would not presume to know. I mean, it can't be easy, and I'm sympathetic. But you know, I think this whole thing goes to what a lot of folks would say is a central tenet of the Trump presidency, which is that making America great again, in the president's words, means making America great for Americans as he and his supporters see Americans. Mm-hmm. And, you know, asking my ethnicity,
right.
I mean, I'm an American.
Right.
And that should be the only thing that matters.
Right.
So I'm not sure what the point was
right.
there.
Well, way to stand your ground.
Thank you, sir.
You've had quite a day. Thank you so much.